Hi everyone, I'm Casey Williams. I have to admit, I've kind of had a love-hate relationship with the Acura MDX. Like most Honda and Acura products, it feels like you could drive it a million years and it would still be just as solid as the day you bought it. But on the minus side of it, you know, the styling's been a little bland. You know, the front grille was kind of not the most exciting thing. And the interior electronics were abysmal. Well, I'll give Acura credit. They fixed at least half of that. So let's go take a look at the car and see why it's better than last year, but there still might be just a little bit of room for improvement. Well, I'll give Acura credit. They made some nice changes to the exterior styling. You know, the first thing they worked on was the grille. And the old grille design, if you remember, kind of had that chrome strip on the top of it. You know, it was a little controversial, and they'd worked on it, but I think this is a little bit better. They call it their diamond pentagon grille. It kind of has the little diamond shapes here in the middle. It kind of sparkles a little bit. I don't think it's quite as exciting, but it's a little more distinctive than the one they had before. And they took that right off of the concept that car they had about a year and a half ago in Detroit. LED headlamps, LED fog lamps, they just glisten at night. And some of the other subtle changes they made for 2017, the grille's been reshaped, just a little more sculpted, nice little peak in the middle, like that. Front fenders redesigned, the lower body cladding is different with the chrome. Again, just looks a little sportier, a little bit edgier. 20-inch alloy wheels. But the rest of it, you know, kind of stays true to the MDX shape. Looks very recognizable. And coming around the back, it's just what you'd expect. Looks very elegant, very clean, very upscale. I like how they put the exhaust outlets to the bottom bumper. Looks very concept car-ish. I think it looks really good. Power rear hatch. And you can see from the luggage space, there's not a lot of it back here if you're carrying two passengers in the back row. But it is pretty easy to put the back seats down, lever, flip them forward. You have a pretty good sized cargo area. And it's nicely carpeted, aluminum trim. Looks very nice, especially with the little tie downs here. There's even a little power outlet for a bicycle pump or whatever else you need back here. So under that shapely new hood behind that brand new grille is a 3.5-liter V6 engine, delivers 290 horsepower and 267 pound-feet of torque. All that routes the all-wheel drive system through a 9-speed automatic transmission. Now talking about fuel economy, 19 miles per gallon in the city, 26 miles per gallon on the highway. I don't think it's phenomenal for basically a crossover with a V6 engine in it, but it's not bad either. And a couple of things kind of help that get to that 26 miles per gallon. One, it has auto idle stop, which means the engine pauses at a rest, like at a stop sign or stoplight, and then when you lift off the brake and put on the throttle, the car automatically restarts. So that helps a little bit. The car also has variable displacement, so it'll shut down three cylinders at cruise or when you don't need as much power. So again, all that conspires to get you 19 in the city, 26 on the highway. And no matter how you're driving the car, and I drove it about 5 hours on the interstate over the weekend, plenty of power, the chassis was settled, you go over bumps and just goes thump, 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 just like you'd expect an Acura Honda to. Very, very nice driving experience on the highway. Well, I wouldn't ride in the third row seat very far. The middle row seat's really comfortable. It's nicely upholstered, the doors are well done, plenty of leg room back here, sunshades in the doors. And there's a lot of amenities back here too to keep you entertained. Look at the size of the video screen. Controls here, you can also remove this. Wireless headphones, you got heated seats, automatic climate control, power inputs here, USBs. Again, all the inputs for the video player down here. If you're gonna bring your personal player along, HDMI. So again, very well equipped back here. Everything you need to stay comfortable and entertained on a very long drive. Let me start with the parts of the interior that I like a lot. Got heated and cooled leather seats in the front in our package. You can get real wood. Everything feels very well made, feels very expensive, just what you expect. All of that I like. I like the leather-wrapped steering wheel. I like all the safety systems. You have adaptive cruise control. You have forward collision mitigation systems, lane keep assist. It's even got a lane centering system, blind spot warning, rear cross path detection. It's got everything you'd want from a safety perspective. So I think that's fantastic. I even like the gear selector right here. Again, it takes just a couple minutes to get used to it, but you got park and reverse, you pull up and drive here. And then there's the button so you can turn off the automatic stop start, which I get in and press it every time. Not the best for fuel economy, but it drives me nuts. Deep storage, again, more USBs in here, and a real power outlet, auxiliary port, everything you could ever want. Here's the DVD player for the screen, if you're not connecting your own. Again, all this stuff. The thing that I think Acura's had a problem with, they know they've got a problem with it, is this two-screen arrangement they've had. Honda does this too. I think it's just ridiculous. They've done some things though to make it a little bit easier, so you can select things easier. So let me go through the functions. You got a camera, you got the full around view camera, which is really nice when you're backing up and maneuvering in tight areas. You got navigation. My phone's not connected, but there's the pairing for the phone. So here's your front audio system. So you got some of your stuff down below. You've got the pre-selects are down here, shortcuts. You can change the audio source if you want to go to AM, FM. Your smartphone connections are all there. But here's the things that I think are just freaking annoying. So to get through to scroll through, you can do it by voice, but then you have to scroll through like this. And you can see about how many times I'm turning this. And I've gone 20 stations right there, satellite radio. So you just keep going through and see it doesn't catch up with you. And when you first turn the car on, it's got to boot up. And it's just ridiculous. So they know they've got an issue here and they need to change it. Actually, they give you a volume knob now. It'd be nice if we just had a real tuning knob. And it'd be nice if we didn't have two screens and had one nice screen that worked well. The good news is Honda has some very nice systems on the new CR-V. So I think they're migrating to a new system. I think a lot of people are going to like that a lot better. Well, then I like the Acura MDX, and I like the changes they made for 2017. I like the new exterior design. I like some of the changes they made on the interior. I think it looks really nice and drives nice. And again, on a really long drive, you can put, you know, four or five passengers in it, a couple kids in the back, and you've got all the space you really need to go on a nice long trip. And it feels like, honestly, like it'll last forever. And as far as the interior and the infotainment screen, they're getting better. And I really do think the next generation is going to be better. And this one's even better than the last one I used. It's a little simpler. And after, you know, after driving 4 or 5 hours with it, I got used to it, and it wouldn't be something that bothered me on an ongoing basis. So looking at pricing, the Acura MDX starts just over $44,000. This one, all in, $59,340. That puts it right there with the Mercedes GLE, puts it there with the Cadillac XT5, BMW X5, cars like that. Well, next week we'll have another fun drive. Until then, storm forward.